language tips. Here today we're going to talk about how to find the correct position and setup. So what we're going to find here, we're trying to find where the arms are in their natural hanging position, okay? In the golf swing, we're always trying to feel good connection in the swing. So we're trying to feel the body and arms would be working together. What we wouldn't want to see is we're disconnected when the arms work away from the body, we'll suddenly see the arms working up into a different plane, vice versa, get too much around the body and don't work in conjunction with the shoulders and body into the backswing. So we've got to get that setup right from the word go. We've got to make sure the arms are in a position where they're ready to work with the body, and then you get the arms and body connected in the first move. So setup wise, we tend to see with coaching, the hands and the arms getting too close but too far away from the body line. So what we're looking for here is my arms to be in a natural hanging position. So if I was to let go of the golf club here, take my golf posture, where my arms hang is pretty much where I want that golf club to be, right? That's where they're going to tend to return back to when they swung at pace. So if we can get the arms in natural hanging position, just sometimes take your golf posture, let your arms hang in, that is where the golf club is going to be. The right hand is always going to be slightly in front of the left at center. This will give you a good indication where the left hand will be, and then the right hand then will just go slightly in front of it. So a couple of checkpoints for you can use. The one I use is take my setup with both the grips, the hands on the grip, and then from here, when I feel like I'm comfortable, I let my right arm hang and relax. So I'm just letting it see where it sits. You can see here my left hand, okay, you can see it's slightly behind. So now I know I'm just a little bit too close to it. So I'm going to move that left arm back in front. So my hands became level, and then I know I'm in a good position. My hand is in a natural hanging position, and I feel like I can turn back and connect my body. Vice versa, probably too far away. If I let my right arm relax, you see it moves into my body, and that shows me exactly where my left hand needs to be. Put my left hand in and straight away back into a better posture. That's the first drill, is using the arms hang and just seeing where they drop back into. That's really important. The second one, just a simple little one, is finger the thumb, outstretch at this, okay? Put it in towards your left groin, outstretch it, and then what you're looking for here is where the finger is, that's where the club will be. That's a pretty good game, okay? So the same, that relationship between the hands and the body never really changes. The club would still be that same distance away in the natural hanging position, regardless of if you're a 4 or a 7 iron or a hand wedge. If the club may be longer or shorter, that relationship always stays the same. So if you use those two tips, the finger the thumb from the left groin, the right hander, outstretch, that'll be the top of the grip, or taking the setup, letting the arm relax, and checking it sits level with the left hand, if you go with it, if it does, you're perfect. If it's obviously more in here, you're stretching, so you need to bring the hands in, and vice versa, if you're too close and your arm relaxes out, you're too close. So using that drill is a simple little way before you start to try to find that position, keep the connection arm, body, and setup, which will help you in the backswing. And then also, you're trying to feel a setup position here, your weight is nicely on the balls of your feet, okay? So sometimes the easiest way to do this is actually just go heels, toes, center. So move back, you can see that. So I'm going heels, toes, center. So I'm feeling the extremes. I'm feeling it on my heels, I'm feeling it on my toes, and then I'm finding the middle. And that's a simple way to define that center position, because it's so easy to get to feel that the heels are centered for you, because you get used to doing it, or to feel the toes are centered for you. So if you can go heels, then toes, then middle, that will help you find the center position. Add that into getting the arms in the correct position, and straight away you're in a great position to create a lovely connection with the backs of the body and arms working together. So use those things when you go to the area, and you should be far more consistent with your ball striking and far more consistent with your swing if you get that nice setup and give you the best chance in the word go. So use those tips,